Hi friends, today let us learn about Pulkesin II's inscribed inscriptions, that is eye-hole inscriptions. Okay, first of all, what is inscription? Inscriptions are the writings or text that are carved on the solid objects such as pillars, walls, temples, forts, stones, and even on the copper tablets. Okay, why eye-hole inscription is called as eye-hole prashasti inscription? Okay, what is prashasti first of all? Prashasti inscriptions are the eulogistic inscriptions issued by the Indian rulers from the first millennium CE onwards. Here, eulogic inscriptions means it deals with the political ideas, the personal accomplishment of the king, his patronage and charity. Okay, these are written in the form of poetry or ornate prose. Here, ornate prose deals with decorated or artistically furnished prose. And these prashastis were generally composed by the court poets. And since it is found in eye-hole, it is called as eye-hole prashasti inscription. Okay, where it is found? This eye-hole inscription is found in Hundhund Taluk in the Balgur district of Karnataka state, on the banks of river Malaprabha. But its fine spot is eye-hole, and it is found in the eastern wall of the old Jaina temple, which is called Mehudi Jaina temple. It is basically found in the temple complex, which is dating back to the 7th century. The language used in this text is Sanskrit language, and it is used script is old Kannada script. And the text is in old verses, and some are not even deciphered yet. The style used here is Kavya style, which is like a poetic style. And the date this is dated back to the Saka era of 556, which is 634 Common Era. Okay, what is Kavya style? Kavya style is like a poetic lines. It's running about 19 lines in this inscription, and it also covers around 18 lines in the normal lines, and the 19th line is apparently shorter and it was later addition, and it has of little importance. The writings cover a space of about 4 feet and 9.5 inches by breadth and 2 feet and half inches height. It is well engraved, and generally it is in excellent state of preservation. Okay, what does this inscription reveal? This inscription reveals the many historical eons, and it reveals the victory of the famous Badami Chalukyan ruler, who is Pulkesin II, ruled from 610 to 642 AD, and the defeat of Harshavardhana in the north. Victory of Pallavas. Here, Harshavardhana was a person, contemporary ruler who was ruling in the north, and Pallavas was a contemporary of Chalukyas who ruled in the south. The shifting of capital from eye-hole to Badami, all this all mentioned in this inscription. And this inscription is chiefly devoted to furnish the eulogistic account of the Chalukyan family. Okay, who composed this eye-hole inscription? This was composed by Ravikirti, who was the court poet and advisor of the king Pulkesin II. Ravikirti compares himself with the great poet like Kalidasa and Bharavi. He describes the Pulkesin's pattern. Because of Pulkesin's pattern, he constructed the temple of Jinandra. Okay, what is pattern? Pattern is like a support, the person who supports the artisans, like the person who is interested in doing so, like charity and all. So, because of Pulkesin's pattern, he constructed the temple of Jinandra. And the initial verses of this inscription runs about Lord Jina's eulogy. Okay, eye-hole in Karnataka state is called as cradle of Indian temple architecture, because Aihole is a place where we can find a lot of temples, and for few notable temples of this place are Durga temple, which is of famous for its unique architectural style, and Ravana Padi cave temple, Kuchi Malligudi temple, Mayilakarjuna temple, and Meghudi Jain temple. There are many other temples, but this is all of great importance. And it is called as cradle of Indian architecture. The inscription which is found in Meghudi temple, which is found in this Meghudi Jain temple, is popularly known as Aihole inscription, which has a significance in the history of India, witnessing for many historical events of Chalukyas. There's mention about the defeat of Harshavardhan, as I said before, and also tells about the victory of Chalukyas and Pallavas. We can see the image given here. It's a Sanskrit inscription of Pulkesi II composed by Ravi Kirti in 634 AD. Okay, Aihole inscriptions mentions about the victory of Mangalesha over Kalachuris and the conquest of Rebadippa Island. And it also mentions about the civil war that took place between Mangalesa and Pulukesi II, where Mangalesa tried to secure the succession of his own son. Okay, who are they? Let's learn about the important rulers of Chalukya dynasty. Okay, Chalukya dynasty was one of the biggest dynasty who ruled in India. Jayasamma was the founder of Chalukyas of Badami. But the actual founder is Pulkesi II, since he developed a lot of development during his period, and the capital was Badami or Vathapi. The religion they followed was Buddhism and Jainism, and Prakrit was their language. Jayasamma was the initial person who started this dynasty. His son Ranaraga was also the next one who ruled the place, but both of them were not independent since they were under the Vatakas rule only. Later on, Pulkesi I was emerged as the first independent and sovereign ruler of Chalukya dynasty, and later his sons Kirtivarman I and Mangalesa conquered the places. Here, Kirtivarman I was the ruler, and after his death, Mangalesa ascended the throne. Later on, when Pulkesi II was the son of Kirtivarman I, you can see it in this timeline. Pulkesi II was the son of Kirtivarman I, and Mangalesa, who is the uncle of Pulkesi II, wanted his own son to ascend the throne. But Pulkesi II defeated Mangalesa, who is uncle of Pulkesi II, and he ascended the throne. Pulkesi II had two brothers, siblings, who were Vishnuvardhan and Jayasamma. Later on, we had many other rulers like Vikramaditya, Vinayaditya, Vijayaditya, Vikram II, but they were not so significant. But the last ruler of the dynasty was Kirtivarman II. He was succeeded by Dandidurga, followed by the Rashtrakuta dynasty. And after the Kadamba dynasty eclipsed, one of the major dynasty that rose to power was Chalukyas of Badami. The power and glory achieved by the Chalukyas of Badami, especially Pulkesi II, is amply reflected in the Aihole inscription. Okay, who was Pulkesi II? Pulkesi II was the son of Kirtivarman I, as I said. He also assumed the title of Parameshwara Sri Prithvi Ballava Satyasraya. He ruled the period of 610 AD. He was the most important ruler of the dynasty. He defeated his uncle Mangalesa and ascended the throne. Aihole inscription gives a detailed explanation about him. He defeated Harshavardhana on the banks of the river Narmada and put a check to the ambition of Harsha to conquer the south. He subdued the rulers of eastern part of Deccan like Kosala, Kalinga, and made his own brother Vishnuvardhan as the ruler, who is already the founder of eastern Chalukyas. In this expedition against the Pallavas, Apulakesan II emerged so victorious. But he later suffered a humiliating defeat on the hands of Narasimha I near Kanji. The chief aim of Apulakesan II was to convert Chalukya kingdom into a big southern empire. They also we can also find the reference that they shifted the capital from Aihol to Badami during the period of Apulakesan II. There we can also find the mention of Kalidasa, but though we don't know the particular period of Kalidasa, but we can see his mention in the inscription. The inscription was twice edited by Dr. Fleet in Indian Antiquary, and it was revised edition was published by Dr. Calhoun in Epigraphica Indica, volume 6. This inscription, as I said, contains 19 lines of writing, poetical writing. Okay, verses. The important verses in this inscription is verses 33 and 34. In the both of these verses, we can find the date of the inscription, like date of the Aihol inscription. And it corresponds for the expired day, year 3735 of the Kali Yuga. Here described as the year of 735 since the Bharata war, and which is the same for Saka Samvat 556 expired. I know that you won't understand anything, but let me make it clear here. We can find a mention in the temple that the date of Mahabharata war, which is like the temple was built after 3735 years of Mahabharata war. From this we can find that the Saka era at that period was 556, which is 634 AD. It's like a common era. And from that, if we reduce the Saka era's period, we get the particular period of Mahabharata war, which is 3735 minus 634, which is equal to 3101 BC. This is the exact period of the Mahabharata war that took place in North India. Okay, this temple built after 3735 years of Mahabharata war. And how can we find this year is the current Saka Samvat era, like the present Saka Samvat era is 1942. So, if we reduce 556 Saka era from the current Saka era, we get 900,942 minus 556 is equal to 1386 years. So the temple was built 1386 years ago. And the original deities of this temple is Durga, but the many misconceptions have led to that Vishnu and Surya is the original deity. But the real truth is the original deity of this temple is Durga. So that's it about the period, the important mention of Mahabharata war and the construction, temple construction. The older name of Aihol was Aiyavol and Aryapura. Chalukyans built in nearly 125 temples here and made the place as their capital. There is a mention in the books that Aihol was a basic place for people who is learning temple architecture. So you can find lot of temple architecture there, like people were learning with the temple architecture during that period. Badami Chalukyas ruled most of the southern part of India from 543 to 753 AD. They declared their independence from the rules of Kadamba dynasty. The earlier Chalukyas were known as Badami Chalukyas, and Apulakesan II was the most powerful king of that time. After the death of Apulakesan II, Eastern Chalukyas made their independent kingdom. Rashtrakuta tried to win over the Badami Chalukyas, but the descendants of Chalukyas overpowered them. Aihol was under Apulakesan I changed his capital from Badami, which is nearby Aihol. On the basis of the temples constructed in Aizawl, Chalukya kings also built temples in Pattadakal. The construction of the temples in Aizawl was started in 5th century, which went to the 12th century. Okay, what were the political achievements of Pulkiyens II? Once having occupied the imperial throne, he did not took much time in planning and implementing a series of military campaigns, both in the home front and outside, mainly to re-establish in full measure the sovereign imperial authority of the Chalukyas. And there were four categories, like four campaigns organized by the Pulkiyens II. And they were campaigns against feudatory rulers of Karnataka who were not amenable to him. Campaigns to the northwest of his empire and his conflict with Harsha. Harsha was the one who was ruling contemporary to him in the north. Campaigns to the northeast and east of his empire, and campaigns to the south of his empire. Pallavas were the one who were ruling contemporary to him in the south. Okay, what are the observations of foreign travelers? Hyun Singh, the Chinese traveler who is contemporary to him, has highly spoken about Pulkiyens II and Emperor Harsha. And the Muslim historian Tabari said, Khusru II, the king of Persia, received an embassy from the court of Pulkiyens II in the period of 625 to 26 AD. And he himself sent a reciprocal embassy to the Chalukyan emperor. There was a legend saying about regarding Aizawl, like the how the place got the name as Aizawl. Like there was a legend called Rishi Parasuram, who killed Rishi Parasuram's father was killed. So Rishi Parasuram killed the killer of his father and came to the river and washed his hands and weapons with full of blood. So the water turned into red, and the lady who saw this was screaming and running, saying Aizawl, which means oh no blood. So the place came to be known as Aizawl. There's also a saying like that. Okay, what are the contents that can be seen in this inscription? In the first verse, we can find that Mangala addressing to the Lord Jinendra, the presiding deity of the temple. And then in the second verse, description of the Chalukya family in which the patron of the temple builder was born. That is of the king Kshatriyashraya, born in the family who was the patron of the temple builder. In the Chalukya family, a king named Jayasimha Vallabha, who was born after many generations. And this Jayasimha was the person who was said to be the initial founder of the Chalukya dynasty. His son was, as I said, Jayasimha's son was Ranaraga, and his son was Pulkiyens I, who made the Vadapia his capital, and his son was Kirti Varman, who conquered Nalas, Maudias and Kadambas. He had a younger brother called Mangalesa, who conquered Kalachuris and seized the island named Revadipa. A long description of his nephew Pulkiyens II, the hero of our story. He forcibly seized the throne. He defeated Appayika and Govinda to turn his side when he had to invade the country north of by Marathi. There were many conquests, and one important conquest was Appayika and Govinda. And this Aizawl inscription suggests two rulers, two of them, rebelled against Pulkiyens but got defeated by him. There was also a mention about a recapture of Banavasi, where Pulkiyens' preceders had subjugated the Kadambas of Banavasi, but the Kadambas no longer recognized the Chalukyas' suzerainty during his regime. Pulkiyens marched against them and besieged the capital of Banavasi. He besieged Vanavasi surrounded by the river Varada. He also defeated Alupas and Ganga of Talakad. Here Alupas were, according to the Aizawl inscription, Pulkiyens subjugated Alupas who had earlier saved as Kadamba vassals. And the Gangas of Talakad, this inscription credits Pulkiyens with the subjugating the Gangas of Thalakkad, who had matrimonial ties with Kadambas. After Pulikesin's victory over Kadambas, the Gangas again accepted the Chalukyan suzerainty, possibly without any military conflicts. He defeated Mauryas in Kongana. After consolidating his power in the southern Deccan, Pulikesin successfully besieged the Mauryan capital Puri, which is variously identified as Garapuri or Rajapuri. He besieged the town of Puri on the sea. Like Chalukyas is surrounded by three seas on each side, and one of the seas is he besieged the town of Puri on the sea. He forced the countries of Latha, Malava and Gujara to seek his protection. He checked the further march of Harshavardhan and all. He took the fortress of Pistapura. He subjugated the island of Konana. He defeated the Pallavas of Konji. The Cholas near the Pandyas were won over from the side of Pallavas to his side. As I said, the important mention was the year of Bharata War. This is the last inscription that has the evidence of Bharat Mahabharata War. And also, the temple of Jitendra was built by Ravikirti. Prashasti. This Prashasti was composed by Ravikirti himself, the builder of the temple. As I said in the prior slides. With the wish for the success of Ravikirti, who was equal to Kalidasa and Bharavi in glory. All these were mentioned in the inscription. And you can see the images in the left side from the book of inscriptions. So, thanks for watching and keep waiting for the next video. Thank you.